This video lecture addresses drinking water treatment, which as you will see is similar in many regards to wastewater treatment. The target in drinking water treatment is to provide high quality water to end users, which is of high enough quality to be protective of human health. First, let's take a quick review of the water cycle. As the U.S. Geological Survey, USGS 2014 notes, water is always in movement across planet Earth. The natural water cycle is also known as the hydrologic cycle, which describes this movement of water on, above, or below the surface of the Earth. Recall that water is always changing states between solid, ice, liquid, and gas vapor. Several important steps in the water cycle include condensation, precipitation, evaporation, transpiration, and other flow paths. Condensation is where atmospheric water vapor is changed into liquid water, and this step is crucial in the hydrologic cycle because it is responsible for the formation of clouds. Quote, precipitation is water released from clouds in the form of rain, freezing rain, sleet, snow, or hail, end quote, USGS 2014. Precipitation is the primary means of delivery of atmospheric water to the Earth, and most precipitation falls as rain. The process by which water changes from a liquid to a gas or vapor is evaporation, which is the main pathway that water moves from the liquid state back into the water cycle as atmospheric water vapor. The USGS 2014 reports that the oceans, seas, lakes, and rivers provide approximately 90% of atmospheric moisture through evaporation. Plant transpiration contributes the remaining 10% of atmospheric moisture. We often hear about evaporation and transpiration in a combined term, that is, evapotranspiration, which is broadly defined as, quote, the water lost to the atmosphere from the ground surface, evaporation from the capillary fringe of the groundwater table, and the transpiration of groundwater by plants whose roots tap the capillary fringe of the groundwater table, end quote, USGS 2014. When we discuss transpiration, we refer specifically to evaporation of water from plant leaves. As you are likely well aware, the water cycle does not have a specific starting point, but the cycle is driven by the sun, which heats water in the oceans. One component of importance when considering water available for human use and water quality is runoff. Runoff occurs when precipitation falls onto land, where the force of gravity acts on the water, which runs downslope. Some runoff enters rivers and valleys in the landscape, and with stream flow typically moves the water towards the ocean. But not all runoff flows into rivers or other surface water bodies. Much of it soaks into the ground as infiltration, with some infiltration recharging aquifers, and some infiltration staying close to the land surface. When surface runoff encounters pollutants, such as agricultural or industrial chemicals, we can see declines in water quality for surface and groundwater sources. As the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, CDC, 2012 notes, drinking water supplies in the United States are among the safest in the world, end quote, paragraph 1. Some typical steps in treating surface water to U.S. drinking water standards include coagulation, sedimentation, filtration, disinfection, and storage. You can see the flow of water through each of these steps and then distribution of the water to end users. As the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency, U.S. EPA NoDate, notes, water treatment may vary by community depending on the quality of the water entering the plant. Groundwater typically requires less treatment than surface water from lakes, rivers, and streams. The first step shown is coagulation. Though there may be pretreatment screening, as depicted in the middle of the graphic, to remove any large debris that would impede water treatment. Quote, coagulation removes dirt and other particles suspended in water. Alum and other chemicals are added to water to form tiny, sticky particles called flock, which attract the dirt particles. The combined weight of the dirt and the alum, flock, becomes heavy enough to sink to the bottom during sedimentation. US EPA, no date. In the sedimentation step, the flock, that is, the heavy particles, settle to the bottom and can be collected through a drain in the sedimentation basin floor. In some cases, lighter materials like oils and greases may be skimmed from the surface, depending on the quality and constituents of the incoming water. Clear water moves to filtration. In filtration, water passes through filters made of a variety of materials, tailored to the quality of the water being treated. Filter layers may be made of sand, gravel, or charcoal to remove different target chemicals and biological organisms. In the disinfection stage, quote, a small amount of chlorine is added or some other disinfection method is used to kill any bacteria or microorganisms that may be in the water, end quote. US EPA, no date. Disinfection targets biological concerns, and while chlorine disinfection is common, other possible mechanisms of disinfection include ozone treatment, which is a strong oxidant, or ultraviolet or UV light. Finally, after treatment, water is held in a closed tank or reservoir for disinfection to take place, and to maintain a specific volume on hand at all times, depending on the size of the receiving community. As needed, the water then flows through pipes to homes and other users, such as businesses in the community. As you might expect, leaks in the distribution system can be costly. An example from Austin Water Utility out of Texas shows that some 11 to 14% of water is lost annually between water that is treated and water that is delivered. As a quick review, the five typical steps in drinking water treatment, as depicted in this graphic, are coagulation, sedimentation, filtration, disinfection, and storage. Pre-treatment and distribution are also important aspects of drinking water treatment and availability. Two possible alternatives to using surface or groundwater as inputs in water treatment are desalination and water reuse, which are gaining popularity across the globe. Desalination is the process of using salt water or brackish water as the inflowing source, which means there will be a high energy and dollar cost for removing the salts and any impurities, as well as disposal costs for the brine. With further technological advances, desalination may become more popular, as some 97.4% of water is salt water across the globe. Currently, desalination is most common in the Middle East and North Africa, or on small submarine crafts, or in other specialized applications. Two possible mechanisms for desalination are membrane filtration and distillation, which is shown here. Membranes are used to remove ions by passing the water through membranes at high pressure, driving osmosis. This is best for brackish water, where solute concentrations are low, and we see this in application in kitchen faucet filters due to it being less expensive and a quicker process. In contrast, the distillation process heats the water until it evaporates and dissolved solids are left behind. This may be energy and cost effective when coupled with power plants that have waste heat. Another possible solution to meet future water needs is wastewater reclamation, where municipalities treat wastewater and route it to gray water uses like irrigating golf courses instead of direct release into rivers, lakes, and oceans. The reuse water is used in place of treated drinking water, thus saving on drinking water demands. One estimate suggests that it costs 8 times as much to desalinate water than to reclaim it. Purple piping is generally used to designate pipes carrying reclaimed water. The following references were consulted in developing this video lecture.